When are you visiting the Philippines?
Hey everybody, we're here at Jollibee in Dumaguete. I'm going to do the Jollibee breakfast taste test. Let's go. Except the menu board is all not breakfast. Where's breakfast? Oh, way over there. I can't see that far. My boot dog, ma'am. Yes, please. Can I get two-piece pancake?
Sorry, sir, we don't have pancake available for now.
No pancake available. Okay, the next one is bacon, egg, and cheese sandwich. Not available either. Wow. Okay, the next one, longanisa. Pizza. Osa. And the next one, corned beef. Osa.
Drinks for that, sir?
One black coffee and one pineapple.
I guess. One piece?
Oh, Dave, what's your one
piece?
Breakfast sticky or
one piece
burger
sticky? One piece burger
sticky. Our order got overtaken. It's okay. I'm retired. So the first two orders, pancakes, which I love, are not available. And the bacon, egg, and chicken sandwich, or sorry, bacon, egg, and cheese sandwich, not available. We'll just keep going. Well, at the end, we can shoot the breakfast menu. I can edit that. So yeah, so I got one longanisa. Osa, longanisa?
Yes, sir.
I'll wait for you to finish there.
Yes, sir.
So that's with coffee, black coffee?
Yes, sir.
Brewed coffee? One corned beef with pineapple.
Pineapple, yes, sir.
The next one is what, your burger steak?
Breakfast steak.
Sorry, sir.
Drinks for that, sir.
Can I just get it without or no?
Without
does it come? Is it same price or?
You can buy it without drinks.
Yeah, I don't need the drink.
What else, sir?
What's the next one I can't see from here? Tapa?
Yes, sir, tapa.
Okay, I'll get one of those.
Yes, sir. Without drinks also?
I'll get a black coffee.
What else?
And the next one is what? One piece chicken?
One piece chicken? Breakfast chicken or just the one piece chicken?
The breakfast one, yeah.
Spicy or is it not?
Spicy, please.
Drinks for that?
No. Voila.
No.
Daily? Did I say daily or voila? Daily. Voila?
Voila.
Okay. What else do you have? That's it for breakfast?
Yeah.
I got everything? Except the ones that aren't available.
So for your breakfast chicken, spicy without drinks, right?
Yeah. I want to try everything. So I got everything? Yeah.
You have longanisa, corned beef, breakfast steak, breakfast tapa, and breakfast chicken spicy. Your drinks is 2 hot coffee and 1 pineapple juice.
Do you think that's enough for me or do we need more food? Huh?
All for 831, sir.
That's enough?
Yeah, I think so.
You're probably saying, oh, you fat foreigner. Huh? I want to do a taste test.
Do you have one test?
I don't. Sorry.
I received 1,000 cash.
Is the ice cream available?
Yes, sir. We have two products, sir. Buko pandan sundae.
Okay. I think I'll have to come and try that for dessert.
Yes, sir. You also have Obi cheese pie.
Just like, do you ever see Beard Meets Food on internet? YouTube? After he eats a big meal, he always has dessert. So I'll do the same. Salamat, ma'am.
You want to try one buko pandan sundae?
I'll get it after.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you, sir, for a while, sir.
Salamat, ma'am. So here we are, waiting for the beeper to go off. Once the beeper goes off, then we go get the food. It's modern in the Philippines.
Yeah.
This is someone else's spaghetti. I didn't try the spaghetti. I'll do a lunch menu another day. So here's what I got. Wow. Just the four dishes, ma'am? That's all? That's all my order? Okay. That's it? Is that enough for one person? Okay. I'm joking. Would you be able to help me, ma'am? I'm in the back corner. Sorry. Everybody, I've got the breakfast menu at Jollibee and Dumaguete. They didn't have two items. They didn't have the breakfast sandwich and they didn't have pancakes. But I've got carne norte, spicy jolly chicken, the burger steak, longanisa, and beef tapa. So I'll start with the one close to me, beef tapa. And here we go. And they all have rice. Also, I've got pineapple juice and black coffee. Let's go. A little beef tapa. Beef tapa is one of my favorite. So I mix a little egg, a little rice. Whoa. That is really lemmy. Wow. That is so lemmy. That is fantastic. I'll have to cover the prices because I know that's a really good price. That is really, really good. I'm going to say 8.5. 8.5 out of 10. Really, really tasty. I'm not going to waste this. Don't worry. I'm going to get it to go in the end. Or maybe my wife and Roselyn will eat it. Huh? Let's try the corned beef. So corned beef or carne norte, which is another staple in the Philippines I love. The brand I buy at home is Delimondo. I love Delimondo. I don't get anything from saying that, but it's one of the best brands. It's more expensive, but it's really, really tasty. All right, here's carne norte. Oh, that's really good. So this is a really good sauce. Carne norte is a bit saltier, but it's very tasty, very meaty. You can see the meat chunks. So a little egg, a little rice, some carne norte. It's also very good. I want to rate this one 8.5, and I know Dave Portnoy would be disappointed. I'm not supposed to change my rating. I'm going to make the tapa a 9.
Breaking news. Score change. Beef tapa, 9 out of 10.
And this an 8.5, because 8.0 is too low. So tapa a 9, it was fantastic. When I ate it, I was thinking of a restaurant we recently had it where it cost 320 or 350 roughly. This portion's smaller, but the taste is really, really good. So 9 out of 10 for the beef tapa, 8.5 for the carne norte. Let's go for the longanisa. And longanisa is basically sausage, I guess. Okay. Oh my God. There we go. Longanisa. It's got a nice flavor. first. So the second one, the reason why I took some from the second one was because it was cooked more. So sauce, I love sauce, so I love the tapa first. This has got a kick to it. It's spicy, the longanisa, but I love spice. So I'm gonna rate that 8.5 also, same as the carne norte. Very good, very meaty. It's dry texture, there's no sauce, obviously. But you could add your own sauce, I guess. And like ketchup, for example, or gravy. There's gravy that came with the chicken. I'll try that in a bit. So I would say 8.5 out of 10 for the longanisa. I'm not sure if they have a non-spicy version. If you don't like spicy, you might not like it so much, but I really liked it. Let's try the burger steak. Burger steak is the hamburger patty with gravy and mushroom sauce. Sorry, a gravy mushroom sauce. I'm gonna take some of my other egg just because I don't want to ruin another egg. And some rice. So, let's go. I love sauces, so I'm expecting this to be a good one. Let's get some mushroom, burger, egg, rice. It's the burger. Get this more egg for my bite number two. Again, I like sauces, so if you don't like sauces, maybe not for you, but I love sauces, so let's go. Bite number two. More mushroom flavor. That's really good. The only thing is for me, it's a bit cold, but we've got a giant air conditioner on the right, a giant air conditioner across from me. So maybe that could be why it's cold. The fourth one I'm trying. I'll rate this an 8.0 out of 10. Very tasty, good mushroom flavor. Just a bit cold for, but besides that, the flavor's good, the taste is good. And now, the spicy chicken joy. Spicy, just like me. I'm gonna break a piece off, use my hands. I hope all those foreigners don't mind. Hello, Filipinos, all around the world. I hope you like this video. Wow, it's so juicy. Look at the juice. It's so nice. And for the American guy who gave Jollibee a bad rating, I want to do this review. Whoa. So moist, so tender, so juicy chicken. This is the spicy one, remember. So it's got some kick. My tongue is burning right now. It's on fire, but I love spice. Now, I'm not gonna double dip my mouth bite. I'm going with the other end. Let's try the gravy. There's the gravy. Hmm. Actually, the gravy tones down the spice, but it's really good. It's creamy, nice flavor, not too salty. I'm tempted. I'm gonna move them. So, here's my two favorite. I gotta give these two, the beef tapa and the chicken joy, both 9 out of 10. I'm gonna give the carne norte and the longanisa, 8.5 out of 10. And the beefsteak, which has the mushroom sauce, I'm going to give the 8.0. Two nines, two 8.5s, and one 8.0.
How would you rate them?
Now I'm going to try the pineapple. I noticed when that American guy tried the pineapple, he had takeout at his house. You can see it's darker in the bottom. It happens in any restaurant when it sits a while for any of the drinks. So I'm just going to stir it just to make sure, because he drank not the true taste of pineapple juice. His was very light on the top. Give it a stir. Now it's got a nice color consistency. There we go. Pineapple juice. Very good. I was expecting it to be more tart. It's not at all. It's got a sweetness to it. I'm going to give that, from a juice perspective, a 9 out of 10. Really tasty, good sized portion. I like it cold. There's lots of ice in here. So 9 out of 10 for the pineapple juice. I should have started with the black coffee because I love hot black coffee. They have a new brewed coffee here, new recipe. And so let's test it. It's still steaming. Can you see the steam? Even after all this long with two giant air conditioners blowing, it's still steaming. Still hot. That's a really good coffee. I know McDo's is famous for their coffee. This competes. This is a good coffee. I like strong coffee. I wasn't expecting much, to be honest. I love my Barako Philippine coffee, which I ordered Philippine coffee from Lipa Batangas on Shopee. I used to go there in person when I was in Manila, but I ordered on Shopee now. This is not Barako coffee, but it's really good. I'm going to give it an 8.5, which is high for a coffee score. I'm a very picky coffee drinker. So, taste number two. Yeah. And I drink it black. And this is 8.5 out of 10. So there's your review. Can I try your Buko Pandan sundae? The girls got this, Buko Pandan sundae. It's new, it's a bit melted. Mm. That's nice. Sorry, Beard Meets Food, I didn't eat all the dishes like you do and then order dessert, but I had a nice taste. That's gotta be a 9 out of 10. It's a really good dessert. I love Buko. And I said it right today. So don't comment that I said Boku. It's Buko, and I know. Because my wife corrects me many times. And the viewers correct me. Thank you for that. All right, that's it. It's your Jollibee review. From Jollibee in Dumaguete, Negus Oriental, Philippines. Thank you very much to my lovely wife and to Roselyn for filming. And hopefully you can hear this video. If not, we'll come and do it again tomorrow. Char. Bye-bye. Thanks for joining us. Please remember to like the video if you do. If you don't, that's okay. Just swipe. Swipe right. Or swipe down. Swipe up. Whatever you're watching on. If you're home, just swipe away. You don't need to leave a negative comment. But you can if you want. You might entertain me. And any comments appreciated? Not anyone. That's not true. Have a great day wherever you are. From beautiful Dumaguete, Negros Oriental, Philippines, it's Canadian and Philippines. Thanks for watching. Watch this next video right here, or right here, or there. I don't know where it's going to be. Please subscribe. We're almost at 50,000 subscribers. Small channels need loving too. Thank you so much. Umping. Ingat. Take care. We have a bonus review. So it's the peach mango pie. I've had this many times, so it's not big, but it makes up for it in flavor. Here we go. This peach mango, it's good. It's purple. It looks like ube.
It says other.
Oh, other. I think this one's ube. It's purple on the inside. Let's see. Oh, it's ube. It's ube? Is that ube? Frozen? So that's ube flavor. So lemmy. So crunchy. So sweet. Just like me. I gotta give this a 9.5 out of 10.
I wanna thank Joepet from Joel Construction. They have two branches in Sibulan for giving me the idea for this food challenge. So if any of you viewers out there have ideas for me, please let me know and I'll try them. Thanks a lot, Joepet.
Let's review the scores for the Canadian and Philippines Jollibee breakfast taste test. 2 at 9.0, 3 at 8.5, 1 at 8.0. Also, pineapple juice 9.0, black coffee 8.5, Buko Pandan Sunday 9.0, ube cheese pie 9.5.
Please subscribe if you haven't already. Check out this next video. I hope you like it also. When are you visiting the Philippines?